Sunday in February. I had to get my months together. I can't believe it's February already. But we are so excited to be back in the house once again with the opportunity to give our God some praise, some worship, some glory, some honor, everything that he's worthy of. We're just so grateful to be in the house once again. And so I have the privilege of starting us off in worship this morning. And I don't know about you, but I'm getting ready. I'm excited for everything that God is going to do for us, because this is going to be a great year. I'm declaring it. I'm professing it now. 2023 is going to be different. It's not going to be like any year we've seen before. God is going to do some great things in our lives. So if you believe that with me, I invite you to join with me in worship this morning, because we're getting ready for everything that God is about to do for us. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard, the kind of blessing that's about to fall on me. 'Cause victory is here, keep defeat out the door.
Something I've never seen.
I'm getting ready. Something
Hallelujah. Yes. We're getting ready for 2023, aren't we? Yes, Lord. It is so good being in the company of the saints this morning. You know, a couple of weeks ago, I celebrated a birthday, and I remember waking up that morning and thanking God for covering me for one more year. But then I realized he covers us each and every day. So we got to thank him for that. And we need to praise him for that. And so that's what we're going to do right now. I don't want to sing the latest song. I don't want to percolate the crowd. I just want to make you smile. I don't care who thinks I'm right or wrong. I don't care who tries to calm me down. I just want to praise you now. You covered me in the midst of it all. You loved me. You gave me another chance. You saw my needs when others saw my faults. You forgave. And I thank you for it, Father. I don't have to listen for my name. They don't have to walk me down the aisle. I just wanna make you proud. Should I make the Hall of Fame? Or they say the special seat? I just hope that you. You covered me in the midst of it all. You loved me. You gave me another chance. You rescued me. I was gonna fall, but you saved me. Oh, you saved me. So in my life. Glorified, yeah, glorified, yeah, 'cause you get the glory and you get the praise, you take the honor. I just wanna say, you get the glory, you get the praise, you take the honor. I just wanna say, you get the glory, you get the praise, take all the honor. I just wanna say, get the glory, and Father, you get the praise. Take all of the honor. I just wanna say, I've come back to say, thank you, Jesus. Well, for everything you've done, Lord. well. For everything you've done, Lord, you get the glory, you get the praise, take all the honor. I just want to say, you get the glory, and you get the praise, take all the honor. I just want to say, take all the honor. I just want to say, you get the glory, you get the praise, take the honor. I just want to say thank you. Hey, thank you. Say thank you to him this morning.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It is now my pleasure to bring to you our Minister of the Month, Elder Kathy Pepley.
Don't stop praising him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who gets the glory this morning? Who gets the praise?
Hallelujah.
Who gets the honor? Come on, you know his name. Jesus Christ, amen. Our Lord and Savior, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We are so glad to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen? Amen and amen. Remember, this is Life Builders Church, amen? The church where we are what? Building people, establishing legacy, advancing families, one life at a time, and that one life includes you. Good morning, good morning, good morning. We are so elated that you have joined us in person here at Pikesville High School, and we also welcome our online viewers this morning, and I'm here to tell you that we have a wonderful service planned for you this morning. Amen. As Brother Ronnie said, my name is Elder Kathy Pepway, and I am the Minister of the Month for February. Amen? And if we know anything about February, it's a short month with only 28 days. But who here knows it is packed with a lot of celebratory events and information? We celebrate Black History Month, Heart Health Month, Groundhog Day, and it's been cold. Come on, somebody. Super Bowl Sunday. Going for the Eagles. Anybody with me? All right. I know a lot of people like Patrick Mahomes, but I participate in a fantasy football league, and Jalen Hurts hadn't let me down this season. So I'm going with the Eagles. It's not too far from Baltimore, so let's go Eagles. All right? All right. So February is also Heart Health Month. It is Valentine's Day or Love Day, and the list goes on and on and on. So if you're going to be tracking with me for the month of February, I borrowed that word tracking from Pastor Torrey Roberts. All right, so if you're going to be tracking with me for the month of February, I plan to share some helpful information that will bless your life. And so I've decided that I'm going to use the word heart. That's H-E-A-R-T. So if you're taking notes, write it down, H-E-A-R-T. And each Monday, I'm going to focus on either a consonant or the vowels so that you'll be able to take something home with you for this month of February. Amen? So today, our letter is H, all right? H is for the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. The Holy Ghost is often referred to as our God. Or a comforter, right? The Holy Spirit guides us into all truth. As a member of the triune Godhead, you know, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, it is the Holy Ghost's job to lead us and direct us into that truth. What is that truth? The Word of God. I don't know about you, but I can't trust my feelings. I can't trust my thoughts. I can't even trust my experience. I don't rely on the world's wisdom or the world's culture. I rely on the Word of God, and the Holy Ghost will help you do that. But thanks be to God that you don't have to stumble into darkness. Amen? That's a good place to say amen. Because the Holy Ghost is freely available to you. You don't have to pay for him. You don't have to, you know, do something to get him. He is free. It was a gift from God. Amen? And so this morning, I'm just here to remind you that the Holy Ghost is your strength. The Holy Ghost is your helper. The Holy Ghost is your advocate. The Holy Ghost is your comforter. The Holy Spirit will never leave you nor what? Forsake you. The Holy Spirit will lead you into truth. The Holy Spirit will help you to obey. The Holy Spirit will give you strength. The Holy Spirit helps us to love. The Holy Spirit helps us to forgive. But most important, the Holy Spirit will help you to surrender. I want you to die to yourself and your ways and truly rely on the Holy Spirit this morning. Amen? So let's thank God right now for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen? So our word for today, H, Holy Spirit. Amen and amen, as we're in this month of February. Now, this is also the first Sunday. And so on the first Sunday, we have communion. So for those of us here in person, we will be doing communion. But I want to encourage those that are watching us online, please go get your sacraments so that as we come to that time of communion, you are prepared and you can participate in communion with us. Amen? And so why do we participate in communion? Come on. I'm going to give you another acronym, CAP, C-A-P. You've heard that before, right? I see some of you nodding your heads. Amen? Why? Because we what? Commemorate. We remember what he's done for us, right? We anticipate, come on somebody, we anticipate that we're going to what? Be with him again and take communion with him. Remember when he was with those disciples? He said, this is the last time I'm going to do this with y'all, but there will come a time, hallelujah, when we will do this again. So we anticipate and we look forward to that time of celebrating with him at that great banquet table. Amen. And last but not least, participate. Amen. We have to participate. So what does that mean? Examine yourself. But also, as the body of Christ, all of us here today and those that are watching virtually, we want to participate collectively, uniformly, and remembering what Christ has done for us, the completed work of Jesus Christ. Amen. And you know what that means? You want to encourage somebody to get to know him, to get saved. So when they publicly see us doing this, why are you doing that? I'm so glad you asked. And you can share with them the good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. I don't know, but it's getting warm in here because we're going to have a good time in the Lord today. Amen? Amen. So our scripture for today is found in Psalm 145. And if you were with us on our prayer call this morning at 6:15 a.m., that was the scripture that was shared. So join me as we look at Psalm 145. I will extol thee, my God, O King, and I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever. What great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise thy works to another, and shall declare thy mighty acts. I will speak of the glorious honor of thy majesty and thy wondrous works, and men shall speak of the might of thy terrible acts, and I will declare thy greatness. They shall abundantly utter the memory of thy great goodness, and shall sing of thy righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are all over his works. Hallelujah. Amen. All thy works shall praise thee, O Lord, and thy saints shall bless thee. They shall speak of the glory of thy kingdom and talk of thy power, to make known to the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of his kingdom. Thy kingdom is everlasting, is an everlasting kingdom, and thy dominion endureth throughout all generations. All right, it's getting ready to get good. The Lord upholdeth all that fall and raises up all those that be bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon them, and thou givest them thy meat in due season. Amen? Amen. Amen. Thou openest thy hand, and satisfies the desire of every living thing, because the Lord is righteous in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is nigh unto all them that call upon him, and to all that call upon him in truth. He will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. He also will hear their cry and will save them. I tell you, the Lord preserveth all them that love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth, I'm talking about your mouth too, shall speak thy praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever. Come on and bless the Lord's name forever and ever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Amen. The Lord is good and gracious. His word is so rich. And I don't know about you, whatever I'm going through, I can find the word of God to help me in that situation. Amen. Amen and amen. All right. So at this time, if we have any visitors that are with us for the very first time, we're going to ask you to stand, and our partners will greet you in the name of Jesus. If we have anybody online who is visiting with us for the very first time, put your name in the chat, and our greeters online, our online greeters, they will welcome you with wonderful emojis and just welcome messages from Life Builders Church. Because we love God's people, and we want you to know that this is a place where you can feel at home. So we just greet you right now on behalf of our founding and senior pastor, Bishop J. Charles Carrington Jr., his lovely wife, Pastor Althea Carrington, who you will be hearing later this morning, the First Family, and all the wonderful partners of Life Builders Church. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen and amen. I tell y'all, thank y'all so much. We're just having a good time this first Sunday of February. All right, it is now time for our declaration. Amen? We're going to say our declaration, and then we are going to hear from our worship leader. And the next voice you'll hear after that will be our own First Lady, Pastor Althea Carrington. And I know she has a word burning in that soul, amen? And I want you all in here, when she gets up and she's ready, you all declare your hands in front of her and say, speak the word of God. Amen? Amen. Let's just encourage her this morning. Amen? Amen. So I believe we have it up for our online viewers, and we have it in-house for all of us that are here today, and we're just going to say the declaration nice and strong and loud. Amen? Amen. I want to get out your way a little bit. All right. So, are we here?
Yeah.
All right. So I don't have to look to the side. Life Builders Church is a church and ministry focused on the agenda of the kingdom of God. We are corporately called to be a people of prayer, kingdom action, kingdom building, and transformers of lives, and builders of people that know their purpose and take their place as productive citizens of the kingdom of God. We have God's mandate. We have all necessary components in place, inclusive of what? Power, provision, personnel, and people. We have men for the vision and people for the word. We have everything we need. We have all that God ordained for us to have, possess, and obtain for his purpose. We are a stable house with longevity. We are relevant, and we are vibrant and fresh, and we impact this generation for his glory. Amen? Amen? Come on, say hallelujah. Amen? What's our word for today? Holy Spirit. Amen? Come on, let's encourage our worship leader, Sister Hicks, as she comes and lead us into the presence of the Lord. And she's brought her backup singers with Kevin and Kaylee. Come on, encourage our youth this morning. Amen? Amen.
I came in the house last night and my children were worshiping, and they asked, could they sing with me today? And so, who am I to tell them no?
Amen.
Come on. Lord, we believe you, loving God, and we believe that you can do the impossible, God. So we thank you for your miraculous ways. We just love you, God. We worship you, we exalt you, God, and we just say, have your way in us. Amen. They say this mountain can be moved. They say these chains will never break. But they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name. We heard that there is no way through. We heard the tide will never change. They haven't
glory to God. Come on, put your hands together. Oh, God, let's give God the glory this morning. Hallelujah. Come on. You say, I believe it. You say, it is done. You say, come on, sing it, saints. I believe you said it. You said it is done.
It is done.
Say it again. Say you
said
I believe it.
I believe
you said it.
Yeah.
It is done.
It is done.
You said it.
You said
I believe it.
I believe
you said it. Yeah. You say,
I believe.
You said it.
You said
it is done.
It is done.
You say,
I believe.
You say,
it is done.
Well, we thank you. We bless you right now. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor, God. We give you all the praise.
Hallelujah.
We worship you right now like none other. Oh, you're the Prince of Peace, the mighty God. You're the bright and morning star. Oh, God, we lift you up right now. We exalt you, oh, God, with our hearts, our hands raised to you. Oh, God, we lift up our hands in your presence. We lift up our lives right now, oh, God, as a living sacrifice. We want you to come and abide, oh God, forever and stay. We invite your presence in this place. Thank you, God. Right now, the atmosphere is being charged with the presence of the Lord. Come on and worship him right now. The atmosphere right now is set for God to do the extraordinary, for God to destroy yokes, for God to heal, deliver, and set free. The atmosphere is set for God to do great things, mighty things, miraculous things. Do you believe it? He said it. Do you believe it? He said it's done. Do you believe it? Hallelujah. He said it. Do you believe it? It is done. It's done. It's done. Whatever you can put your hands on, whatever you can see in your imagination, whatever you've been waiting for, crying for, believing God for, whatever you've been weeping at night, weeping in the morning, weeping at night, God said, weep no more, because I'm here. I am here. I am here. God says I'm here to dry every tear. I am here today. You said, I believe it. We believe it. You said, it is done. Come on, you said, say with me, you said, I believe. You said, it is done. Come on, you said it. Come on, act like I believe it. You said it. You said it. You said it. It is done. In the name of Jesus, put your hands together. Thank you, God. Come to abide with us. I'm your handmaid. I yield my life. I yield, oh God, my heart to you. Have your way. Get the glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm just a little excited this morning. Amen. And the word and what he's about to do.
Amen.
I'm going to ask you one more time, put your hands together and give God the praise. You say with me, it's all about him. I said it's all about him. Nobody else. Come on, it's all about him. Nobody else. Amen. You can be seated right now if you want to, if you choose to. I thank God, amen, for this morning. I praise God for our bishop in his absence. And amen, he's on his, he'll be way on his back, way, he'll be on his way back later today. But we just want to give God the glory, honor, and praise. I want to thank God. I want to turn, amen, your attention to, amen, hallelujah, couple of verses of scripture, amen. And forgive me because one is a little lengthy, but it's necessary. Amen. I want to read Romans 12, 1 and 2, and then Acts 9,
1 through 20 and then 22, Romans 12, 1 and 2, and then Acts 9, 1 through 20, and then 22, verse 22. And I don't believe I will be here, up here very long, but we're going to do what God said do and then take our seat. Romans 12, 1 and 2. And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you, or plead with you, to give your bodies to God because of all he has done for you. Let them be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind he will find acceptable. This is truly the way to worship him. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Say the way you think. Say the way I think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Acts 9, 1 through 20, then verse 22. Meanwhile, Saul was uttering threats with every breath and was eager to kill the Lord's followers. So he went to the high priest. He requested letters addressed to the synagogues in Damascus, asking for their cooperation in the arrest of any followers of the way. Any followers of the way he found there, of the way meaning Christians. Amen. He wanted to bring them, both men and women, back to Jerusalem in chains. And he, as he was approaching Damascus on this mission, a light from heaven suddenly shone down around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Who are you, Lord? Saul asked. And the voice replied, I am Jesus, the one you were persecuting. Now get up and go into the city and you will be told what you must do. The men with Saul stood speechless, for they heard the sound of someone's voice, but saw no one. Saul picked himself up off the ground. And then when he opened his eyes, he was blind. So his companions led him around by the hand to Damascus, and he remained there blind for 3 days and did not eat or drink. Now there was a believer in Damascus named Ananias. The Lord spoke to him in a vision, calling, Ananias. Yes, Lord, he replied. The Lord said, go over to straight street, to the house of Judas. And when you get there, ask for a man from Tarsus named Saul. He is praying to me right now. I have shown him a vision of a man named Ananias coming in and laying hands on him so he can see again. But Lord, exclaimed Ananias, I've heard many people talk about the terrible things this man has done to believers in Jerusalem. And he is authorized by the leading priest to arrest everyone who calls upon your name. But the Lord said, go, for Saul is my chosen instrument to take my message to the Gentiles and to kings, as well as to the people of Israel. And I will show him how much he must suffer for my name's sake. So Ananias went, found Saul. He laid his hands on him and said, Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road, he sent me so that you might again or receive your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit. Instantly, something like scales fell from his eyes. He regained his sight, got up, was baptized. Afterward, he ate food, regained his strength. Saul stayed with the believers in Damascus for a few days. And immediately he began preaching about Jesus in the synagogue, saying he is indeed the Son of God. All who heard him were amazed. Isn't this the same man who caused such devastation among Jesus' followers in Jerusalem? They asked, and didn't he come here to arrest them and take them in chains to the leading priests? Saul's preaching became more and more powerful, and the Jews in Damascus couldn't refute his proofs that Jesus was indeed the Messiah. Amen. We thank God for his word is already blessed. It does not need to be blessed. It's already blessed. Amen. We thank God today. You know, in scripture, as we find, there are many people in scripture who had different experiences. They had different experiences with being conformed to the world. All right. Conform means well adjusted to your culture or our culture, that you fit in without even thinking about it. Amen. You just, you fit in. You just do what everybody else is doing. You just go where everybody else is going. Why are you going? I don't know, because everybody else is going. Well, that's probably not the way we want to live our lives. Amen. But there are people, these people I'm about to mention, they had major transformations in their life. They had a major transformation. God did extraordinary things in their lives because they were transformed, not in their own doing, but they were transformed by what? The power of God. Say the power of God. Come on, say the power of God. Amen. So we have Moses, who was a murderer, right? But God transformed him to be what? Leader, great leader of Israel. We have Rahab the harlot. Rahab, what did she do? Help the spies to spy out the land. She hid them so they wouldn't be murdered, right? Amen. And God remembered her. We have Ruth the Moabitess, who was an idol worshiper in her country of Moab, where she came from. But God did what? He rose her up. She watched the life of Naomi, and God did extraordinary things in Ruth's life. She was transformed by personal evangelism. Amen. Her mother-in-law. Jonah was prejudiced, and what did God? God used him mildly to preach, amen, to the people of Nineveh. Amen. The woman with the alabaster box of ointment. She was a prostitute, and God delivered her. He said, "Where are your accusers? There are no accusers. Go and sin no more." The woman at the well, an adulteress, God healed her, delivered her. What did she do after God transformed her life? She went and told, he said, "Shh, don't tell nobody. Don't tell nobody." But she went and told the whole city what God did in her life. Somebody said, "Yes, hallelujah. Glory to God." We have Zacchaeus, a tax collector, who was a thief. He cheated the people. But one day Jesus came by and said, "Come on down out of that tree, Zacchaeus." Zacchaeus climbed up the tree because he was a short man. He said, "Come on down today. I'm going to have lunch with you." Glory to God. The thief on the cross. The thief on the cross. The thief on the cross. Told you I was excited. Thief on the cross. The day Jesus was crucified, he was up there beside Jesus too. And he realized his life was going nowhere. He was about to enter into eternity. And he knew his life was not right. So he said, "Jesus, save me. Jesus." And he said, "Today you'll be with me in paradise." How about that? Amen. You're about to die and experience and go, amen, to your final destination, not knowing where you're going. But then Jesus, the Son of the living God, says, "Don't you worry about today. By giving your life to me, you'll be with me in paradise." The centurion, who was an uncircumcised Roman officer, amen, yet he had faith for his servant, that his servant would be healed. God transformed. And God is in the business. He's in the business of transforming lives. Amen. Aren't you glad about it that God is in the business of transforming lives? When I think about, amen, when I was a little girl, I think about things, and I had visions in my mind, and I remember things that happened. I remember, amen, what God did. I remember seeing people playing cards and drinking Bacardi and rum. I remember seeing, amen, people gamble. I remember seeing things in my head. And you know what? That time, I didn't know my future. Amen. How about you? Did you know your future? You were like 5 and 6 years old. You didn't know what was going to happen. You had nothing before you. Nothing before you that was a pattern. Nothing before you. All you saw, amen, was people around you. Amen. That the way they were living, and you seemed to think for a while, "Well, this is what it is. This is all there is." But one day, amen, come on, one day, didn't God do it for you? But one day God did it for me. Hallelujah. Wish I had a little bit of comfort, but that's all right. Listen, one day, what God did, he showed our family the way. Somebody shared the gospel of Jesus Christ with us. Amen. And showed us, look, there was a better way. We went to this church, small church. It's all right, because I'm saying it was our everything. It was our everything. It was our musical. And amen. It was our way to show us how to live. proof, the life. It was the way to show us we could do anything. It wasn't until we knew and turned to the Lord, the Lord showed us you can do anything. There ain't nothing too hard for you to do. You can do, you can be anything you want to be. I didn't know that. You didn't know that one day until God came and ministered the truth to you. Glory to God. Amen. We should know that. I mean, all these people, and he used many other people that were imperfect. Amen. They were imperfect. They had things, skeletons in their closets. They had things that was nothing to be desired about many of them. But God stepped in. Hallelujah. And it changed everything. Hallelujah. And look, he calls us his own. He calls us his own. Oh my God, oh my God. Sometimes when you ain't got nobody around you to push you, say, go on with the bed. Ain't nobody around to tell you. You can do it. But God said, I'm pushing you. It's me pushing you. I'm pushing you. I'm telling you, you can do all things and you won't fail. You won't fail. You won't fail. Oh, God. Sometimes a battle going on in the mind. There's a battle and a war going on in the mind. The enemy is saying, you can't. You won't. You didn't. Nobody else did. So you won't. Don't expect nothing. Don't expect it. And what God says, in me, you can do all things. All things. All things. Why? Because I strengthen you. There were two people in particular I want to speak on today. I want to spend most of my time speaking about these two individuals. There were many other disciples. Many other disciples that, amen, we could draw from, we could think on, we could remember. But in particular, there are two that God wants me to focus on this morning. And they are Peter and Saul. Peter and Saul. Peter was often known as the disciple that Jesus loved. He loved all the disciples. But there was a special kind of love, you know. And I know, you know, we don't like to say we got no favorites, you know. And our children, we got no favorites, and our grandchildren, we ain't got no favorites. We love all the same. Okay, all right, yes, all right. But you know, there's a special love for the baby, a special love for the middle, special love for the firstborn. They're not the same. The love is there. Love may be the same, but it's a special kind of love for that baby and for that firstborn. If you got ones in the middle, 2, 3, 4, 5, I can't help you. I'm sorry. But I'm just saying there's a special kind of love for that first and for that second. Amen? The second for the first. But Jesus loved Peter. And he was a fisherman. He was from the tribe of Naphtali. Simon means he has heard. Say, he has heard. Peter means rock or little stone. Say, rock or little stone. Uh-huh. So Jesus asked a question to his disciples one day. Why do men, or who do men say that I am? Uh-huh. Peter answered, thou art the Christ. Woo, Jesus, hey, God, hallelujah, thou art the Christ. Jesus replied, flesh and blood has not revealed that to you. Peter said, the Christ, you know what? I'll never leave you. I ain't gonna never leave up on here. I ain't gonna leave you. I ain't gonna leave you. Jesus said, Oh, Peter. But when the cock crow crows 3 times, you'll deny me each time. No. How many have some people, some friends like, girl, you might as well go, girl, we BFF. And then there's some time BFF forever can't be around. All right, you got a cool dude, ace book, cool, and all y'all did it. When I did everything, one day it's like, oh, man, I'm gonna need somebody. Ain't nobody around. There are times when even you can be married. I'm just saying, you know, I know, like Bishop, Mr. J. Charles King, ain't nobody like him. He is my, hey, he's my everything. He's my rock. You know, he is, you know, strong. I got pet names for him. I ain't gonna share them with you. I got special, I might share them on this week coming up, but I ain't gonna share them right now. But listen, I'm just saying, you know, yeah. But there are sometimes in areas that only Jesus can reach. And it's meant to be that way. In summer camp, I'm not talking about if I'm not feeling well, or you can't get me no soup, you can't go get some tissues, you can't get me some, you know, something that I really want from the store. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about there are some things in the inside, hard things, issues that only God can reach. So let me just make sure I got that clear. Because if you ain't doing what you need to do for your wife or your husband, all right? I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about heart issues, matters, spiritual issues that only God can, he can do. So he denied Christ. But can you imagine how he felt when everything played out? The cock crowed 3 times. Oh, miserable. Felt miserable, right? All right, but amen. Anyway, he denied him. He was the very night Jesus was taken away. But Jesus called Cephas. Jesus commissioned him. Still, I've already prayed and interceded. I already prayed for you. Jesus has already prayed for you. I don't know what you're going through, but Jesus already interceded for you that you won't faint, that you won't fail. Oh, I don't care what you heard. And I don't care what you are hearing in your mind right now, but God has already interceded for you. And I'm telling you today, say today is a new day. Today is my breakthrough. Today is my awakening. Come on, you ought to give God the praise. Give God the glory. Hallelujah. So anyway, he said, Peter, you are the rock. And upon this rock, I will build my church. So Peter, he said, feed my sheep, feed my lambs. And he traveled, Peter traveled all around the country, traveled everywhere, teaching, preaching the gospel. Amen. He's the author of 1st and 2nd Peter, and he preached to 3,000 souls that day, on the day of Pentecost. And guess what? They were all saved. You ought to give God praise and put your hands together and thank God for the miraculous. That doesn't just happen. All 3,000 souls were saved that day. Amen. Saul, say Saul. Saul of Tarsus in Acts 8, we see Saul is pulling Christians out of their homes and putting them in prison. He had just, in the book of Acts, Acts 7, he witnessed the murder of Stephen, who was stoned to death, and they laid the clothes at Paul's feet, saying, it's finished, it's done. We've done what we're supposed to do. He was a bad as in bad. Not good. He was not good. He was really bad. I mean, everybody feared Saul. Everybody feared him. Amen. He was also known as Paul. And in case you think that his name was James Paul, his name is Saul Paul. Saul Paul. All right. Saul Paul. All right, so it wasn't until later, 9 years later after his conversion, that he was called the Apostle Paul. But Saul means asked for from God. Paul means small or humble. Amen? And he was from the tribe of Benjamin, named after, guess what? King Saul. That's bad. Say yuck, yuck. All right, he was named after King Saul. He was from the tribe of Benjamin, just like King Saul. Amen? He was what you would know as an Hellenistic Jew, all right? An Hellenistic Jew. That's what Saul was known for, meaning that they believed in prosperity and progress in the arts, literature, theater, architecture, music, mathematics, philosophy, science, amen, during that era. So he was very well educated, all right? But he was known as a heretic because of his doctrinal opinions. He killed Christians while traveling on his way to Damascus. He had a life-changing experience. He became blind, as we read. And the Bible says that he had to be led around by his companions. He had an encounter with Jesus on his way. Now, Saul never met Jesus face to face. This was his first encounter with Jesus. As he was on his way to Damascus, he was on his way, actually, to find Christians and find Jews and find them in the synagogues, pull them out and bring them back, all right, to be judged, all right? So that's what his mission was, to go to Damascus, and Jesus stopped him. My God, Jesus stopped him. He became blind. Jesus said, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? This conversion took place over a period of 3 days. Initially, after God was finished, no one believed that he was converted. God so told Ananias, come on, get up. You got to go meet this man and pray for him. He'll be filled with the Holy Spirit. You got to go meet him. You're like, oh no, do you know about him, Jesus? Do you know about him? He's not a good person, all right? But he, amen, was obedient and did what God said. He ministered to Saul. Hallelujah. Paul's ministry consisted of ministering to the Gentiles, and he authored 13 books of the New Testament. Now, this type of transformation is costly. This kind of transformation that Paul, that Peter, and many other disciples experienced, it was costly. Why was it costly? It was costly because they lost their lives. Many of them, not all of them, but many of them lost their lives. Preaching the gospel, teaching people, transforming people, saving them, pulling them out of darkness. Hallelujah. I have a question. The question I have is, what gifts, what talents, what gifts do you have that you're not using? What gifts do I have that I could be using for the kingdom of God? What gifts do you have that you could be using for the kingdom of God? See, when these disciples, and back in those days, the disciples, they were radically changed, radically delivered, radically set free, that they couldn't even keep it a secret. They couldn't keep it a secret. They ran to the city, ran to towns, ran home to their families. After God had done something amazing in their life, and they had to tell it, even Jesus said, shh, shh, my time is not yet come. My time ain't come yet. Don't say nothing. They couldn't help but tell it. They told it. They told it from the mountain. They told it from the housetop. They told it, amen, from the rooftop. They told and they shared about what God had done. The Bible says, be not conformed to this world. Mm-hmm. To conform means, again, having an outward shape, a form or an expression by following the same pattern or mold. Uh-huh. As we as women, we know we don't all like to look the same. Mm-hmm. We could buy the red dress or the blue dress or the black dress, and it could be, you know, but we don't always want two pockets. You know, we don't want the pocket, all the pocket here. Not if we're all going, you know, maybe I'm with a husband going on a date or going somewhere or whatever, or an evening out. We don't all want to always look the same, do we? No, we don't want to do that. So that's sort of like, you know, telling everybody you always got to wear the same thing whenever you come. Wear the same. It's like, oh, no. Nah, I don't want to look the same, like, all the time. All right, but being conformed is just like that. Being the same on the outside. Being the same. Being conformed to the norm and status quo. Hey, Jesus, my God. Same pattern, same model, same mold. So well adjusted to your culture that you fit in without even thinking. We don't even think about it. I mean, I don't even give it a thought. I'm like, just, okay, go here, okay. No, no, no. The Bible Bible says, be transformed. Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Do not be conformed to this world. Because if we're conformed to this world, we do everything everybody else is doing. Who can find us? We can't be found. We can't be distinguished as being the people of God. Be not conformed. Same way of thinking, same way of doing. But be transformed by what? The renewing. Jesus, the renewing. Not just one time, but it's ongoing. Renewing. I'm constantly what?
Renewing.
I'm constantly what?
Renewing.
I'm constantly doing what?
Renewing.
Be transformed by the renewing. You can't do it, y'all. We can't do it on our own. We done tried it. We done did it. We try to do it our way. We try to do it somebody else's way. We try to do it. It don't work. We got to be transformed by the renewing of our mind. How are we going to do that? First of all, renew means completing a process which intensifies. Who says it's going to stay the same? It's this way this year. Oh, it's not the same way last year. The next year, no, it's different. Okay, so 2 years from now, all right, it's different again. Why? Because you're ever increasing, going to another level. That's the walk. That's the Christian faith. That's the walk. That's how we grow. That's how we develop. You're renewing. Don't stay in the same place. Don't stay in the same place. Sometimes you gotta lay your hands on your own head. Wait. I'm bringing these thoughts under the subjection of the Holy Ghost. It ain't happening here. Get out. The blood of Jesus is against you. Y'all scared? You're not scared, are you? Come on. Come on, go with me. Renew, completing, or, amen, a process which intensifies to make fresh. It takes place from the inside. Conform, think outside. Yeah. What everybody else is doing, I don't even think about it. When you don't think about it, you have not put any kind of personalization to it. You haven't really considered the cost, the outcome, what it's going to take. When you conform, you just go. You don't think. There are people that are living that way today. We're not thinking. We're just doing. Why? Okay, everybody else is doing it. Why are you going there? Oh, girl, it's a thing to do. Everybody else is doing it. But why are you wearing that? Oh, it's a style, girl. Everybody else is doing it. Oh, God, Jesus. You know, everybody else is doing it, so it's in. Let's do it. God said, no. I want you to think. And transformation means I got to think about this thing. Oh, my God. I gotta think about it. You know, Saul was just doing whatever he had to do because he felt like he was doing the right thing. And Jesus faced it. He had an experience on that Damascus Road. He said, wait a minute now, you ain't thinking. You persecute my people. You persecute my land, my people. Come on now. Come on. No. What are you doing? What are you doing, Saul? What are you doing? So, Pastor Al, so come on. How do I renew my mind? How? It's not enough just to know you need to. It's not just gonna know that it's necessary, but come on, how? How do I renew my mind? We renew our mind by the word of God. I'm gonna give you my cheat sheet, okay? Alright, so you can take notes if you want to. I'm gonna give you my cheat sheet. It works. Come on. The word of God is not my cheat sheet. It's Jesus. He gave it to me. I'm going to give it to you. It's free. I don't want nothing for it. I don't want no credit for it. I want you to give him glory. How do I renew my mind? I renew my mind with the word of God. The Bible says, faith coming by hearing, hearing by the word of God. Faith coming by hearing, hearing by the word. By the word, by the word, by the word, by the word, by the word of God. It sounds like, oh, okay. But it works. It's what we need to be renewed. We got to be transformed only through the Word of God. It's not through self-help. I mean, self-help books, you know, we are authors, and we know that we took time and believed God to give us the answer. And we really studied and really got before God to put what God gave us in those books. But if those books were not immersed with the Word, you shouldn't be even reading them. You shouldn't be reading them. I'm talking about books like The 490 Factor, all right? Books like, you know, Bishop Has Written, and then Transformation Theology. You're immersed in the Word. We get tired. We're like, okay, so I tithe. Ain't nothing happened. It's been, how long has it been? A week. Okay, I prayed for God to heal it. Ain't nothing happened. How long you pray? 2 days. So, I was going through something. I had something major. What is it? Something major I was believing God to do. I'm like, okay, God, I'm forgiven. I'm forgiven. But God said, okay, stay there. And forgiveness is important. I'll come back to that in a minute. But when you really, really are in the fight of your life, something major is going on in your life. You're in the fight, you're down with the count. How much time do I have? You're in the down with the count. You've got something major going on in your life. You're going to roll up your sleeves. You're going to take off your shoes. You're going to open the door if you have to and kick everything out. I'm not talking about people. I'm talking about anything that's not from God in the spirit realm. You're going to be in bed. You're going to get up in the morning and you're going to, all right? You're going to do business. You're going to pray. People say, well, I don't believe in warfare all the time. I'm not saying warfare all the time, but until you get that release, that breakthrough, turn off the TV, turn off the radio, turn off your movie, until you get the release. And you get the release by quoting the Word of God. And you get the release from taking yourself aside. Get off the phone, stop talking about it. Stop talking about it. Stop talking about the situation. Open up the Bible, look in the concordance, and look up areas in scripture that fits your need, that you need God to move and the breakthrough to come. You take those scriptures, you put them on index cards, you put them on the refrigerator, you put them on, you know, wherever you're going to be, on your computer at work, or computer at home, you put them on your bathroom mirror, you put them and you quote them. You get up in the morning, you quote those scriptures, you confess them. You go to bed at night before you go to bed, you confess those scriptures. That's what you do when you are in the fight of your life, when you need your mind renewed and you didn't have the help that you needed maybe when you were younger, or you don't have the help around you that you need. This is what you do, because the enemy walked about, amen, as a roaring lion seeking whom he can devour. And no one here today should be devoured. You're not going to be devoured. I'm speaking the truth of God today. He told me to tell you, you will not be devoured. I want you to take everything in you. He's given us the ammunition. He's given us everything we need to defeat the enemy. Every foe, you ought to give God praise. You ought to give God the praise. You ought to give him the glory. You can't any longer walk around with your head hung down. I went through a period of my life when my brother died. I don't really think my brother died on time. But when he died, I was a mess. I didn't know what was going on. I did not know what was going on in my head. My images in my head, I saw him dying, and I saw his body wasting away. And I stayed with my mother, because at the time she was like 80. So, and I couldn't let her go up to that room every day with her baby hair laying there wasting away. I mean, we had to do some things I never thought I had to do in my life. I saw things, I mean, I just didn't know. It just really did something to my head. It took me years to break through that thing until I realized that the enemy is the culprit. He is the reason. He wants to destroy. He don't love you. He don't love you. He want us dead. He would be a good daddy if you were just dead. And I bind and rebuke right now. I take authority right now over the spirit of suicide. There's a spirit of suicide that's running rampant today, mostly among men, black men for some reason. And I arrest the spirit of suicide. I take authority right now over the spirit of suicide. Not in this house, not ever in this house. Not upon our children, not upon our girls, not upon our, no one. We arrest suicide. In Jesus' name, we're going to get up. We're going to do this little exercise in 1 minute, and we're going to begin to combat some things and bring some things under subjection. God said forgiveness, repentance, amen. We got to repent. We got to turn. Actually, turn 180 degrees from where I am to another direction so that I can see change. Repent. God says we need to repent of some things that maybe we allowed to fester in our hearts, things that we allowed to carry on in our hearts. Amen. Forgive. God said, you've been carrying that thing too long. Let it go. But Pastor, you don't understand what they did for me. I know, baby, I don't understand what they did to you. I know it was wrong. But sometimes, and I know that we gotta really go, but I know that sometimes we really think that, you know, we're right, they're wrong. But what if with everything you had within you, Jesus died on the cross, he believed for people, for all of us to see him. He believed that we would see him. He believed so much that he said, amen. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. If he can do it on the cross, we can do it too. Amen. We can do it too. Yield to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yield to the Holy Spirit. Tell somebody about your transformation. Rehearse the triumphs and the triumphs of others in your mind. Expect great things. Repeat. Stand on your feet right now in the name of Jesus. Everybody stand on your feet real quick. Stand on your feet. I'm going to ask you right now. Sometimes we have negative thoughts going on in our head. And sometimes when those negative thoughts are in our head, they take residence. They don't want to go. There's a saying that says it takes three positive things to combat and wipe out any negative word or negative occurrence. So I want us to real quick, I know we're going to have to go in a minute, but I want us real quick, I want you to survey who's around you. Amen. We have the Petways here. We have the Watties back there. Amen. We have, amen, Sister Robin, and we also have, amen, we have Sister Cherise, and we have Kevin, and we have others back there. Just look where you are. And we also have Mom. We also have India. We have, amen, Talia, wherever you are. I want you to begin right now. In the name of the Lord, I want you to begin to just, and when I count to three, begin to speak and decree. The word of God says we can decree a thing and it shall be established. I want you to look to your left, look to your right, look in back of you. Amen. The Petways are going and the Watchies are going to be together. You don't have to move. Stay right where you are. Don't move. Stay where you are because prayer knows no distance. We're going to decree the word of the Lord upon your life right now, upon your mind, your business, your home, your marriage, your children, your children's children, the grandchildren. Amen. Begin to decree the word of the Lord. Decree good things. Amen. You will prosper. You will live. You will be blessed. You are the beloved of God. You're blessed, healed divinely. Amen. You're prospering in the name of Jesus. 1, 2, 3. Go. Begin to right now decree. Amen. I decree upon you right now as you're listening. Come on, begin to open your mouth. You can turn around, look at each other, and just begin to decree. Don't move. Don't, amen, don't touch. You don't have to touch anybody. Just begin to decree. And back of you, in front of you, amen, beside you, decree for India, any decree for you. Amen. Everybody decree. Should be opening up your mouth and decreeing, amen. hallelujah, over everybody's body, amen, over their lives, over their, amen, their children, their families, their jobs, for healing, for deliverance, for the best year ever, for breakthrough, for, oh God, signs, what I decree right now over everyone listening on our audience, amen, I decree the word of the Lord, I decree breakthrough, signs, wonders, miracles, healing, abundance, I decree that this is the greatest year, you're walking to the greatest year of your life, you are moving and doing extraordinary things, you will not die, but you will live and declare the word of the Lord, you are prosperous, you're the blessed, you're not cursed, you are walking in, you are, amen, shining, moving, growing, developing. You are the head, not the tail. God has great things in store for you. You are the blessed. You're not cursed. You're healed. You're set free. You're delivered. Your children's children will rise and call you blessed. You're the anointed. You are the beloved of God. Hey, everywhere you go, people will find you blessed. Everywhere you go, people will call you blessed. You are the anointed. You are the blessed. You are walking in breakthrough. This is your best season. What didn't work last season is going to work this season. What you did not see last season, God's going to show you great, miraculous things. You are the beloved. You are the beloved. Everybody shout glory. Come on, shout glory. Come on, shout glory. Shout glory. Shout glory. Decree again. It is so. Come on, say it is so. It is so. It is so. It is so. In the name of Jesus. It is so. It is so. We're going to nail that thing right there in the ground. Put your hands together. Give God the glory. Come on and give God the praise. Magnify him. Glorify him. Glory to the name of God. I feel his presence right now. I feel the glory of God. I feel the anointing. I feel there's a breaking going forth right now. I decree right now and declare in the name of the Lord. Yes, his word is established. And I'm thinking different. You go home and you do what I asked you to do, what the Lord told me to do. Find those scriptures and declare and decree them over our mind. We're not going to be any more conformed to the world because everybody else is saying it. Everybody else is doing it. See, sometimes we take people with us. Sometimes we take people with us and think the way we respond, the way we act. And God said, well, you got to go. I need more out of you. Amen. And I got more for you. Because there are people that are waiting and watching. There are people that are, you don't even know it. They're attached to you. They're saying how you break through, how you break out of this. You got children that are watching you and saying, how are you handling? How are you breaking all that? Because you understand, amen. Monkey see, monkey do. Amen. You're not monkey. But I'm saying that they watch and they do the same thing. They repeat after us. So because of that, you owe it to yourself. And you owe it to those that are following you to be the best you can be. Glory to God, glory to God. This is the greatest backdrop ever for if you need Jesus today. If you need Jesus today. Amen. All you got to do is ask him to come into your life. I don't know what you've been. I don't know where you've been. I don't know what's been going on in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. But amen. You got to admit that you are a sinner. Admit, amen, that you have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Believe in your heart. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that what? He gave his only begotten son that what? Whosoever believes in him should not perish but will have what? Everlasting life. We want you to have everlasting life today. Amen. Just like that thief gave us life to Christ on the cross. Amen. Today, you don't have to wait till the end of your life, but you can do it right now. Give your life to God. Amen. Give your life. Amen. Commit to being a believer in Christ. Confess with your mouth, Jesus is Lord. And believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, and you will be saved. Amen. We want to thank God for you. If you have said that with us, we welcome you into the kingdom of God. Let's all put our hands together and rejoice over one soul, two souls, 10 souls, 30 souls, 100 souls that are listening to this, the rebroadcast. Come on, put our hands together and bless the Lord and thank God for our family that's expanding in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Amen. Amen. This time I think we're going to have communion. We're going to move right into communion. Amen. A little longer, babe. Amen. The fire of God is here. Amen. The anointing of God is all over this place. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Just before, while they're preparing. Amen. Just want to pray. I don't know if there's anyone who needs prayer, anyone who is believing God to do something for their life. If you need prayer, if you need God to do something, amen, why don't you raise your hand? If you need God to do something, if you're believing for prayer, you need to be healed, you need, amen, God to do something for you, amen, you can come forth right now, come down right now in the name of the Lord. Amen. If not, I'm going to stay there. Father God, I thank you right now in advance for those who are raising their hands, sister. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, God, right now in advance. Whatever, oh God, you're standing in need for, whatever you're standing in need for, you may need healing, you may need God to do something special for you on this week. And right now, we just decree and declare, we release our faith for God to do extraordinary things for you. We believe God to do, amen, miraculous things in your life. This is a turnaround. This month, amen, is a love month, as we just said, but it's also a turnaround month. It's a turnaround time for you. Amen. I just decree and declare right now that your days are about to change. God's going to do extraordinary things. I release my faith. We all release our faith. We join in and believe right now in advance. But God is doing extraordinary things, great things. Release our faith. Whatever you're in need of today, healing.
Thank you.
You need God. You need a job. You need God to work in your family.
Thank
Amen.
You.
Believe God. Let's believe God.
Thank
Release
you, God.
Some faith for God to do
Thank you, God.
The miraculous.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, let's put our hands together. If you don't have your communion cup. Yes.
Amen.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God. We have bread of heaven. We can begin to play that if we have it. Bread of life. Sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth. A holy king of carpenter, you are the living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Awesome ruler, gentle redeemer, God with us, the living truth, and what a friend we have in you. You are the living word. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, we thank you in advance. We thank you for this moment that we commemorate your death, burial, resurrection. Remember the work you did. You said, as often you do this in remembrance of me. Remember you. You did it all for us. You did it all for us. You paid the price. I thank you, God, right now for healing. I thank you, God, for your presence. I thank you for your anointing. I thank you for your power. I thank you for the breakthrough. I thank you, God, for your presence right now. Now bless us, your people. Seal us with your blood. Get the glory. Get the honor. Get the praise. Be glorified, oh God. Be magnified. We give you all the honor, glory, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to ask none other than Elder Kathy to come in and take us the rest of the way. Amen. God bless you. Thank God for you. Amen. The power of a renewed mind. Amen. Let's give God glory. Come on.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Come on. You can do better than that. Let's show our woman of God. We thank God for using her this morning with their word. Transformation, right? Renewing of our mind, amen? We got work to do.
Amen?
But she laid out a plan for us today, amen? Of what we need to do for that renewing of our mind. That's what? Consistent. She said renewing. Renewing. It's happening all the time, amen? Amen, amen, amen. We thank you, Pastor Al, for that word today and for you allowing God to use you mightily for the kingdom of God. We remember those 6 points? She gave us the word of God, yield for the Holy Spirit. Tell somebody about your transformation, amen? Rehearse yours for others and rehearse your triumphs, I'm sorry, and the triumphs of others in your mind. Expect what? Great things and then what? Repeat, say it again, repeat and repeat, amen?
Amen.
Amen. Come on, let's give a round of applause and just praise the Lord. For all that he has given us today. We got a feast today. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Remember, renew your mind. Renew your mind. Get your scriptures out for what you are going to ask God to help you through. Put them on your refrigerator. Or put them in your planner. Put them on your phone. Whatever it is that you need for that constant renewing of your mind. Transformation. Because that what? That devil is trying to devour you. But not today. Amen?
Amen.
Amen and amen. Amen. All right. If you worship with us, you know that right now it is what? Opportunity time. Come on, say it loud. It's opportunity time. Amen. And we get excited at Life Builders Church when it is opportunity time because this is our time to give, be generous. Think about all that God has done for us. Just thank him that we are able to sow seed into the work that he is doing, amen, in our lives. And then what? Prove him. Prove his faithfulness. Prove the word that Pastor Al told us today about. His word is true. And he will, what? Give you a return on it, amen?
Amen,
amen. Amen. I want to remind us for this month, as we've been doing for the many years here at Life Builders Church, we sow first fruits, right? We give God first what is his. And Bishop has asked us to sow in a denomination of 23. It's the 23rd year. So you can give, as Bishop would say, $2,023, $223, $23. All right, but however God has blessed you, and we want you to sow into this ministry, don't forget your first fruits seed. And again, in a denomination of 23. Amen. All right, so we have a declaration that we read over our tithes and offering. And so join me in saying, Life Builders Church has generous and faithful tithers and givers. Your generous giving adds value to this ministry. So now is what?
Your opportunity to give.
Amen.
Amen
and amen. Online, we have several ways that you can give. Our chronicler has them up on the screen. So if you want to give online, if you want to give by mail, here in person, we are getting ready for our offering in person. Those of you that are online, please watch the slides, and it will give you your methods of giving. I want to instruct the audience here, the partners, that you are going to come down the respective inner aisles. Our ushers and greeters will be leading you. and walk up the outer aisles, all right? So it is your time that we're going to give. I'm going to ask if I can, have K3. K3, if you'll come up, Deacon Vince will give you a basket to hold on this side, and you can put your offering in. And do I have someone on this side? I'm looking for Kaylee, but I don't see her. Can I get Anaya? Is Anaya near? Anaya, would you help me out on this side? For those that are coming on this side, if you could come and hold the basket, Brother Ronnie has it. And our music ministry, if you could just give us a little bit of music, just so that they will be ready to give at this time. Follow the lead of our ushers and greeters. Brother Ronnie, I'm going to let you, if you don't mind. Follow the lead of our ushers and greeters at this time, and we're going to give. Amen? Thank you. Amen. Amen. prize for just getting so many couples to register. All right, we had a deadline for that contest, and Elder Lavina got on her task, and she just did a phenomenal job. But there is still room. We are not sold out yet, and it's virtual, so please, please, please pass along this information. All right. The next thing is just a reminder that we do in-person worship every first Sunday, like we're doing today. And so our next in-person worship is Sunday, March the 5th, 2023, 10 a.m., right here at this same place. So please tell others, we want to see more coming out to our in-person worship. It's nothing like assembling together as the body of Christ. Remember during Pastor Al's service, she talked about when the 3,000 were together and all on one accord, God moved tremendously and they all got filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen. So we want to encourage you to come on out. Don't get complacent and being away from the body of Christ, because it's easy when you're away to drift. It's easy to drift. But if you're here in person and you stay connected with the body and your partners, I'm telling you, you will have an awesome time. You'll get that fuel and that energy that you need to combat the enemy. Amen?
Amen.
Amen and amen. All right. Youth and young adult breakout sessions. All right. So every third Sunday during worship, we're going to have breakout sessions for our children. And the children will need a Zoom link and a Zoom login. So parents, we're asking you to assist your children so that we can identify them and move them into the breakout rooms. And we want to make sure that they participate in our youth breakout sessions. And this month, the breakout sessions are going to be so important, because that last Sunday, we hope to have some displays from our youth. So come on, parents, make sure that your youth join us every third Sunday during worship. And they get to go into their own breakout session. Amen? Amen and amen. All right. Men, say woo.
Woo.
All right. Y'all can do better than that. Men. All right. All right. All right. All right. Our men's prayer breakfast will be Saturday, February the 18th. At 9 a.m. at the Randallstown IHOP. That's 8696 Liberty Road, Randallstown, Maryland. You can see Deacon Vince. His number's on the screen for more information. What I hear when he comes back home, they be having a good time. So I don't think you want to miss this. They get out and talk and just have a good breakfast, fill their bellies, and have a wonderful time. So please, if you haven't, join our men's prayer breakfast on Saturday, February the 18th. We have been studying Bishop's theology book and on our Wednesday impact sessions, and I'm telling you, you don't want to miss these sessions. So every Wednesday, our impact groups meet at 7:30 p.m. The Zoom information is on the screen. Please try to join in so that you can participate in those discussions and all the information that we have going on. Amen? Amen and amen. And as I mentioned early on when I gave the scripture for today, Psalm 145, you can join us for prayer every day from 6:15 a.m. to 6:30 a.m. and Wednesdays at 6 p.m. And the phone number and access code is on the screen. I want to just say an announcement, and it is not in your slideshow, but let me just tell you how the Lord works for people. And based on what Pastor Al was even preaching about today, I'm sure that she got her strength just to be here this morning from the Lord. And that is our own Sister Robin. If you don't know our own Sister Robin Lewis, mother transition is with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And do you know that Sister Robin is here in person at church today? Come on, church, let's give her a hand. I mean, she has made arrangements for her mom, but she didn't think it would be robbery. She wants to still come and worship and fellowship with us and give praises to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Come on, that takes strength. I know it's nothing like a mom. That takes strength. So I want you all to love up on her today, but I do want to give you the arrangements this information. So it's going to be held at the Pleasant Zion Baptist Church. Again, that's Pleasant Zion Baptist Church. And that's located 4317 North Point Boulevard down in Dundalk, Maryland, 21222. Again, Pleasant Zion Baptist Church, 4317 North Point Boulevard, Dundalk, Maryland, 21222. Now, the public viewing is this week. It's on February the 9th, from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. And the public viewing is going to be at the church, Pleasant Zion Baptist Church. And then the next day, February the 10th, the funeral will be on February the 10th. So the wake starts at 10:30 and the funeral at 11. And if you need additional information, just let us know. You can also see Sister Roz, our outreach coordinator, who assists whenever we have members who have loss in their family. Amen? Amen. So y'all love up on Sister Robin. Sister Robin, we love you, and we're praying for you, and your Life Builders Church family is with you. Amen?
Amen?
Amen and amen. All right, if you remember, just one more thing before we say our declaration. The letter for this month, for this Sunday, is what?
H,
right? Because the word that we're going to be working with, if you're tracking with me, is heart, right? Heart. And H stood for the Holy Spirit. Amen. And then Pastor Al just came back behind and talked about the Holy Spirit and what the Holy Spirit does. But as I told you, a lot of things are going on for the month of February. So H is for Holy Spirit, representing our Black History Moment. H is for Harriet Tubman. Everybody should know about Harriet Tubman. If you don't know, she's a hometown Maryland girl, right? She over in the Eastern Shore, all right? Many people don't know that. When they hear the stories about this abolitionist, Harriet Tubman, I think a lot of people think down the South or someplace far away. She is from right here in Maryland, right down over the bridge on the Eastern Shore. And if you know anything about her, she was a slave, she was an abolitionist, but she was freed, amen? And guess what? She got about business. She said, I'm free of my family and my friends and anybody else. And she did a phenomenal job of moving people and getting people out of those conditions. And believe it or not, she had the nickname of Moses. You know, remember Moses in the Bible? He let people out, right? But, and you might not look at it that day because a lot of people don't want to think about slavery, but she was a humanitarian, believe it or not. And she felt, it was my job to help. It's my job to help. So I want to encourage you today, help somebody. All right? It's okay to help somebody, you know, to encourage them. If they have something that's going on, an injustice or something of that nature, support, be an encourager, and help. Amen? And then last but not least, your other H, because it is Heart Health Month, try and make sure you have a heart-healthy habit, all right? Heart-healthy habit, so that H word is habit. You know what Bishop says all the time, if you do something for what, greater than 30 days, it can become a what? A habit. So there are many different things that you can do for heart health. So to my viewers online, put in the chat something that you're doing to improve and increase your heart health. You can what? Make sure that you do some type of activity or walking 30 minutes a day. You can say that I'm going to eat more what, vegetables and fruits. I'm going to drink a certain amount of water a day. All right? I'm going to practice not smoking or drinking. All of those things that contribute to your heart health. Amen? So I want to encourage you, whatever it is that you might need to do. It's not set in stone. You got to look at your life and determine what heart health habit am I going to pick up, and then I want to encourage you to do that. Amen?
Amen.
So that's our H word for the day. Stand to your feet, because we have had a wonderful day here in the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Come on, let's act like we done had a good day.
Amen.
We're going out here transformed, renewed in our mind, ready, equipped, telling the devil, bring your best shot, because it's not going to stick.
Amen.
All right? All right. And as we do here at Life Builders Church and online, say with us, God dwells,
God dwells
in the midst of Life Builders Church.
Life Builders Church.
God dwells,
God dwells
in the midst of a blessed community.
In the midst of a blessed community.